Final del Campeonato del Mundo Canadá 1999. Categoría Welter. Protector rojo. Elena Benítez, España. Campeona del mundo, campeona olímpica. Tres veces campeona de la Copa del Mundo, dos veces campeona de Europa. Protector azul. Mirjam Nuskens, Holanda. Subcampeona del mundo, subcampeona de Europa.
With the female welterweight finals, Nuskens from the Netherlands is going against Benítez from Spain. Spain in the red in the finals here. Round one action. Already getting a warning right off the bat.
Elena Benítez had a fantastic comeback in her semifinal match to pull off.
Oh, look at that. Nice.
Canada. Good combination there by Elena Benítez.
She didn't get anything there, but you know what? Right off the bat, when you do something like that, Joe, it shows your opponent what you can do, and it tends to give them a little bit of, you know, makes them stand off a little bit.
It's going to cause their opponent to be a little bit more apprehensive. Elena Benítez is here to fight and here to win, and she's letting the Netherlands know. As we said before, Elena Benítez is a seasoned veteran to these games. She's been at many world championships, has been representing Spain for many years now, and one of their top fighters.
So she knows what she's doing?
Yes, she does. And a nice back kick attempt right there.
Score is still 0-0. Spain in the red corner, and in the blue corner we have the Netherlands. Round one, action. Oh, did you see the height on that kick, Joe?
That was a beautiful axe kick attempt by Elena Benítez.
She is not a tall girl.
No.
And that was way up there.
I really like the follow-up that she did right after that with that back kick. Good movement by Elena Benítez.
Time out for some reason here.
She's going to tie her chest guard back on. Came loose.
And also gives the coach a chance to let her know what he sees that she may not be seeing. And of course, being a veteran that she is, she's going to be listening to everything he says.
That's right. She sure is. She knows that the coach is going to give her some sound advice, and she knows that as a good player, she needs to take that and try to do what she can with it.
Just over a minute left in this first round.
Now, Nuskens from the Netherlands has proven to be a very tough competitor all day and has done some fantastic fighting here throughout the day. Coming up with
nice
a score right there, and she knew it. Great confidence.
Roundhouse. Most scores in these fights are either headshots or roundhouse kicks.
You know, your roundhouse kick to the body is your staple when it comes to Olympic sport taekwondo. Almost everything stems off of that kick, Robin. You're going to see 95% of the points scored today, and in any other championship, are scored with that roundhouse to the body.
Little exchange there. No points exchanged.
A few seconds left in this first round of our final match.
Of course, the crowd getting into it again.
That's the Netherlands King Chang on the player.
And that is the end of the first round. Let's recap on this.
You see the Netherlands attacking with that lead leg roundhouse. And again, one more time, Spain tries a double kick. And now she comes back down. Looks like Netherlands will switch maybe and get that lead leg. No, first tries to push. Here comes the point coming up here.
Wow.
And right there. Spain a little bit off balance, trying to get out of the way, but couldn't do it in time. Netherlands, great timing and scores the point.
And here we go with the round two of this final female welterweight championship. Netherlands in blue and Spain in the red.
Score right now is 1-0 starting the second round. But as you saw earlier, Elena Benítez can't be counted out yet.
Could we please have Master Sudo Kim from the United States to the administrative
table? We'll halt in the action then. Benitez looks a little bit tired now.
Well, as you can see, Bob, she's a really active fighter. She's constantly spinning and jumping in the air. You have to have tremendous stamina to be able to continue that through an entire day's competition. And again, most of these fighters have already had 5 fights to get to this final match.
Nice attempt there. As she falls down, she's kicking.
Score is still 1-0.
Zero.
The Netherlands fighter is doing a fantastic job.
But as you know, it's the last match. You can't count Spain out because she was down by 3 points and came back to win against Pac from Canada. And I think the Netherlands team knows that.
Yes, they do. You know, the Spanish fighters, again, known for their intensity and for their vigor out there. Elena Benitez will be coming back. There was a point.
There you go. She did come back already.
She came back, got 1 point now, gets it close.
Just over a minute in the second round here. And that was close. The push kick to the front.
Really, Benitez has to be careful about her balance so she doesn't get caught off guard again.
Well, I've been impressed with both these girls, Pac from Canada, and also this one from the Netherlands, Muskins. Both these fighters have showed us great fighting today.
Yeah, they have, and like we said, the Netherlands really impressing a lot of people here at these championships today. Score remains 2-1 as we're in the final seconds here of our second round.
Just about 10 seconds here.
Referee breaking from the clinch.
And that's it. The end of round two.
There's the fast kick that scored Muskin's second point. Again from another angle.
Right
underneath the arm on the side of the chest guard. And there's her excitement.
And here we go with the final round of the female welterweight. Third round, Muskins from the Netherlands in the blue. And Benitez from Spain in the red. The score is 2-1.
Nice headshot.
Nice headshot. 2-2.
Again, Benitez coming from behind in another match to tie the score.
Now see, she was behind 2-0. And like we said in the last match, she came back from 3 points to win the game. And now she's tied the game. So you cannot count her out. And she ordinarily makes her moves in the last round, early.
There's only 3 words that I can say to describe what she's able to do, and that's experience, 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 Bob.
That's right. And I mentioned earlier, she looks tired. That doesn't matter. She'll keep going, tired or not, because she's got that experience and she knows what it takes to make it through the whole 2 minutes, or 3 minutes, excuse me.
See Benitez setting up something. Muskin's wary of it.
Wow, what an exchange.
Both these girls very fiery in the fight. Kick and that scored.
That scored. Nice pass.
Benitez ahead. 3-2.
Like I said, you can't count Benitez out. She'll come back.
she goes again.
Fantastic back kick and follow drum. She just scored another point. And U.S. pulls away now. 2 points
ahead. She went from two behind to two ahead in a matter of about 3 minutes. Punching Muskins to the chest there, showing her I still got some energy here.
You know, Rob, that's what we like to call absolute confidence. This girl from Spain really impressing everybody by coming back twice.
Oh, wow.
Good exchange there, yeah.
And she
scores again.
Another score. But actually, they both scored there. Benitez is still 2 points ahead with about a minute and a half left in this round.
Great exchanges again. Benitez absolutely wiped out energy-wise.
Oh.
But she's still going. Look at
that. Wow. What an excellent match this is, and Muskins does not want to let this go easily.
And Elena Benitez.
That is it. That is the fight. And Benitez wins the gold medal here in Canada at the World Championships. Wow, we can
see that. Big roundhouse to the head.
She was behind.
What flexibility.
At the beginning of
this. That tied it up right there. That tied up the score, and Muskins didn't know where it came from.
Boy, she just hung that foot on her head.